Beloved, I greet you in the name of Jesus Christ. I'm Pastor Felumo Shesson, the host of Living by Grace. I thank God for another opportunity to come to you. And I believe one of the greatest gifts that the Lord has given us is the gift of grace. For the life that the Lord gave us in Christ, it's a good life, beautiful life, empowered, strengthened, and enriched. But we need the grace of God to be able to live that life and enjoy the benefits that are in it. And that's why I'm giving thanks to the Lord that you are joining me today with several other members of the family of grace for today's broadcast. For I assure you that through the word of the Lord today, you will be engraced to live your life in Christ. Thank you. Yeah, welcome back. Today we are discussing a scripture that will bless you with grace to go out there and bear fruit with your life. But before we go into the discussion of today, let's have this time to pray. Let us pray. Our Father who art in heaven, we thank you in the name of Jesus for the grace that you have consistently dispensed through this platform. Every time that you reach out unto us through this platform, you dispense grace. We are grateful to you for it. We thank you for the grace that you will dispense today, and we receive it with thanksgiving. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Hallelujah. The text for today is from John chapter 14, verse 12. And I will be reading it from the ESV version. John chapter 14, verse 12. I read, "Truly, truly, I say to you, whoever believes in me will also do the works that I do. And greater works than these will he do, because I am going to the Father." I take it again. John chapter 14, verse 12. "Truly, truly, I say to you, whoever believes in me will also do the works that I do. And greater works than this will he do, because I go to the Father." The topic of our discussion today is, you can do better. Yes, you can do better. Because of Jesus. Because he has gone to be with the Father as your advocate, you can do better with your life than Jesus did with his life. If you can do better with your life than Jesus did with his life, then you know that you can do better with your life than your fathers did with their lives. You can do better with your life than all your predecessors in every sphere of your life did with their lives. Better than your father did, better than your mother did, better than your forerunners did, better than your superiors in your place of work or in your line of business or practice did. Beloved, because of Jesus and because he has gone to be with the Father, and one of the reasons is on your behalf, you can do better today than Jesus did with his life. The question therefore today is, how can I do better? For like I said, the topic is, you can do better. In the text we read, Jesus revealed the secret behind you doing better with your life than he did with his life. Yes, you can do better. Irrespective and despite the fact that things are the way they are, in whatever country you are listening to me, you can do better. It doesn't matter the situation of the economy of your country. It doesn't matter the situation in your marriage. It doesn't matter the situation of your health. It doesn't matter the state of your business. It doesn't matter the level of your education or status in the society. Because of Jesus, from where you are today, beginning from today, you can begin to get a better result than anybody has ever got before you. Hallelujah. So the question is how? In this scripture we read, John chapter 14 verse 12, Jesus revealed how. He said, "Truly, truly, I say to you, whosoever believe in me will do the things that I do and will do better things than I did." But the key is believe. Now, what is Jesus saying? What does he mean by believe? He's saying, if you believe that you are who God says you are in Christ, if you believe God, who says if anyone be in Christ, he is a new creature. And several verses in the Bible reveal the identity of that new creature. So he's saying, if you believe in yourself that you are who God says you are, if you accept the identity that God gave to you for your faith in Christ, he's saying, if you accept it and you embrace it and you begin to appropriate it as your identity, who God says you are, everything that Jesus did with his life while on earth, you will do it with your life now that you are on earth. And he went further to say, you will even do better with your life at this time than Jesus did with his life at his time. Yes. That is what Jesus meant when he says, if you believe in me. In addition to him meaning, if you believe in me that I am who I say that I am God. In addition to that, your belief about who Jesus is, if you now go further and appropriate the belief to yourself that you in Christ Jesus, you are who God says you are. Beloved, everything you read in the Bible that Jesus did in his lifetime, you will do it in your lifetime. You will heal the sick. You will walk on water. You will still storm. You will raise the dead. You will make money to come out from least expected places. You will. Because Jesus said so. And Jesus is God. He can never lie. He says, God says, if you believe in Jesus, you are a new creature. Like I said, the identity of that new creature is explained in several verses of the Bible. For example, in the book of Galatians chapter 2, from verse 15, one of the identity or the characteristic of that new creature is that the life of that new creature is the life of God. He says, the life that the new creature lives is the life of Christ. He said, it is no longer I that lives, but Christ that lives in me. Can you believe that about yourself? That you are no longer who you used to know yourself to be, but now you are an embodiment of God. Can you believe that about yourself? that you are the image of God. You are the reflection of God. You know, 1 John chapter 1, verse 1 to 3. 1 John chapter 1 from verse 1 to 3 spoke about Jesus being the manifestation physically of that life of God that we read about. He said that which we have read about in the beginning, we got to see it with our eyes. We got to hear from him with our ears. We got to touch him with our hands in Jesus. Meaning Jesus was a physical manifestation of the eternal life. You, according to the word of the Lord, for your faith in Christ, you have become the expression of Jesus, who is God in a human form. It is no longer you that lives. Your life is now the life of God. Hallelujah. So Jesus is saying, if you begin to see yourself as a living, walking, breathing manifestation of God, then everything you do, it will be God that is doing it through you. And if it is God that is living your life, meaning, if it is God that is doing the things you do, then you will agree with me, nothing will be impossible for you. There is no mountain that you will not be able to level. There is no storm you will not be able to steal. There is no need you will not be able to meet, because it is not you. It is God. Now, the implication of this is this. If you believe that it is God that is now living in you and living through you, number one, you will have authority. The effect of that knowing and believing is that everything you do will be with authority. What I mean by it will be with authority is there will never be doubt in your mind that whatever you say will come to pass. There will never be doubt in your mind that whatever you call will come. Because you know that it is the Almighty God that is living in you. And you know about God, that with God all things are possible. Jesus says, all power in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Do you believe in yourself? Somebody wrote, he said, the measure of a man's faith is his confidence in himself. A man's faith is measured by his confidence in himself. Are you confident in yourself? Do you believe that you are who God says you are? If you believe, and you put that belief into practice, it will appear in the form of confidence and authority. For example, the Bible records about Jesus that consequent upon the way he conducts himself with respect to how he handles situation, the people around him, the Pharisees and the Sadducees, noticed that he spoke with authority. One verse says, and the people say, what manner of man is this? For with authority he speaks, an unclean spirit obey him. So you see, the power in Jesus' ministry, the secret of it is that Jesus had authority. In Luke 10:19, Jesus said, I give you authority. In 2 Kings chapter 5, when Elisha visited the widow of Shunammite, Elisha did not close his eyes to pray. Elisha said to the Shunammite woman, by this time next year, you will have a child. And she had a child. So, I'm asking you again. Do you want to do better in life with your life than Jesus did? If your answer is yes, then this is the secret from the mouth of the Lord. You need to believe in yourself that you are who God says you are in Christ. You have the life of God in you. God is the one that is at work in you. And that's why Jesus said in Mark 11:24, that whatever you ask, believing, you will receive. Nothing will be able to say no to you. And so I commend you to God that as you go forth from here, you will go in the authority of Jesus, and whatever you decree shall come to pass. There are those who quote the scriptures. The devil does not respect them. And there are those who declare the word of God with authority. The ones that declare the word of God with authority, they are the ones that the word of God in their mouth never fall flat on the ground. Be authoritative. Be expectant that what you say will come to pass. Why? Because of who you are. The Lord bless you. Until I see you next week, keep living under the atmosphere of grace. If you look at the screen, you will see our information. You can get across to us. We are waiting to hear from you. But before I pray for everybody, I'd like to say this. If you are yet to give your life to Christ, this is the opportunity. Only after you have given your life to Christ does the Lord give you the authority that will enable you to live and achieve better results than Jesus achieved in his lifetime. And it's very simple. Confess your sin, ask the Lord to forgive you, and then surrender your life to Jesus Christ. Once you do that, you are born again. Until I see you next week, God bless you. Let us pray. I hereby commend you unto the grace of the Lord God Almighty. The Lord bless you and keep you, cause his face to shine upon you, and be gracious unto you. In Jesus' mighty name, I have prayed. Thank you for listening. God bless you. We'll be right back.